the student has surrendered to the teacher, his faith in the teacher cannot be shaken. The teacher knows, and having that faith in the teacher, I have come to the teacher. And therefore, if there is some question in my mind, it is not out, it doesn't become my assumption that the teacher is wrong, but my assumption is I have not understood. What that is called humility. Look at the way students ask questions now. Think. Questions are not wrong, but the attitude of question has to be right. So he says, katham etad this point that you were born later, sun was there earlier, sun god was there earlier, katham, how, vijaniyam, how can I understand it properly? You are not wrong, Bhagavan. Whatever you said is correct. Because my intellect is not mature enough to understand what you say. Because you are Bhagavan, you are my guru, I am your shishya, and therefore, please tell me. What a beautiful way. If we study Bhagavad Gita, we will understand the essence of our culture as to how to deal with people. Even how to scold, Bhagavan teaches. Is it not? Not the words, huh? How beautifully he teaches, hey Arjuna, how come you got into this position? See? This is how we should scold. Not that you are a fool. And then that person will ask, how did you know after so much time? I thought you will know much earlier. Even scolding has to be done that it inspires the listener. What a beautiful idea. Hey Arjuna, you are so great, how come you fell? Arjuna will feel, yeah, correct. He feels inspired that Bhagavan scolded and he says, please, little more you scold me. And thus, he asks, please tell me, how am I to understand this point that you were born later, sun god was there earlier, but you say that you taught sun god. And now Bhagavan reveals his true nature for this first time in the Bhagavad Gita. Let us read the verses 6, 7 and 8.
5.
Oh, 5, sorry. Let us read verse 5, yes.
Shri Bhagavanu Vacha. Bahuni me vyatitani janmani tava charjuna tanyaham veda sarvani natvam vetha parantapa.
Bhagavan says, hey Arjuna, natvam vetha. Hey Arjuna, what is the reason you don't know? The reason you don't know is because you don't know. Natvam vetha. Why is that I don't understand? Because you don't know, that's all. And therefore, hey Arjuna, I will tell you, bahuni me vyatitani. Vyatitani have passed. What has but bahuni, many, many, many have passed. You know this word bahu, not the Hindi bahu. Bahu itself means many in Sanskrit. And here Bhagavan is using plural of many. What is plural of many? Many, many, many. So not one, not two, not many, countless. What countless? Janmani. Janmani, many, many, many janmas have passed. Of whom? Bahuni me vyatitani janmani tavacha Arjuna. Tavacha. Yours also. Yours also means mine also. So, hey Arjuna, many, many, many janmas have passed of yours and of mine. Then what happened? Tanyaham tani, those aham, tanyaham veda sarvani. I know all the words. Natvam vetha. Hey Arjuna, you do not know all those birds. You know only this bird, but I know all the birds. I am omniscient. I am sarvajnaha, and therefore I know all the birds. And Bhagavan says in the second chapter, not only you, Arjuna, not only me, Arjuna, everybody in this Mahabharata battlefield has been going through so many janmas. And what? Tani aham veda sarvani. Sarvani doesn't only mean I know all of my birds. Bhagavan is saying I know all of my birds, I know all of your birds, and I know all of everybody's birth who ever came, who will come again. And that is me, O Arjuna. And thus Bhagavan here establishes the understanding, the idea, the siddhanta of punar janma. The concept of rebirth. All of us yesterday saw that birth is only for the body, death is for the body. You are and I are different from the body. So body has birthday, body has death day, but you and I have neither birth nor death. We only pass from one birth to another birth. And today we always look towards the West for proof. Psychologists, psychiatrists all over the world have recorded findings of evidence of rebirth. If you want to read, read Brian Weiss, a very famous psychiatrist, psychologist, Chicago Hospital. He heads the psychiatry department there. Read his books. And it's very clearly seen. Evidences are there very, very, very clear and profound. Children below the age of 3 who are not so obsessed with this particular birth, they are quite aware of their previous births. It is only when our mind gets so occupied with the events and things of the present birth that the past is forgotten. Just because I don't know something doesn't mean it is not there. Or doesn't mean that event never happened. What did you eat on June 20th, 1994? Do you remember? That proves you did not eat anything on June 20th, 1994. Is that correct? What has happened? That event was not very important, and therefore I have forgotten that event. But do you remember the day of your marriage? How many years back? Somebody said, Swamiji, so many years back that if I had life imprisonment, I would have been released today. 12 years back. So major events of our life we remember. Even in this birth we have forgotten so much. Is it not? What about past birth? And it is good that we forgot. This birth likes and dislikes itself we can't handle. And if you remember all the wives you had in all the births, what would happen? You will get confused. And if you remember all the husbands you have, what will happen to you? To whom will you be devoted? Problem, social problem. Is it not? This birth's guilt itself is so difficult to handle. What about guilt of? So therefore, Bhagavan, out of his compassion, he wipes the memory slate clean and says, start again. Doesn't matter what you have been in your previous birth, you can make your life wonderful in this birth. See what a beautiful option. And thus, you and I are not some sudden accidents that have happened. We all are wonderful progresses that have happened over millions of births, and today we are all sitting here with this level of intelligence. And thus it is said, jantunam narajanma durlabham. To be born as a human being is very, very difficult. And therefore, hey Arjuna, make use of this. Do not waste it. Why? Because next birth we don't know. Seriously. And even if you are born as a human being, next generation society is going to be worse than what is today. Correct? Therefore, better realize this birth. Is it not? Bahuni me vyatitani natvam vetha parantapa. Hey Arjuna, therefore you do not know what are the different births that has been taken, but I know. And now Arjuna has a question. What is his question? Bhagavan, yes. You are also born again and again and again. I am also born again and again and again. I thought problem is there only for me. You are also in the same boat. I am also born again and again and again. You are also born again and again and again. What is the difference between us? Correct? எனக்கு இருக்கிற தொல்லை உங்களுக்கும் இருக்கு. So what is the difference? Is there any difference between your birth and is there any difference between my birth? Bhagavan says, that is the difference. No doubt both of us are born. No doubt both of us are doing actions. But yet, the difference is there. And what is the difference? That Bhagavan will tell in the forthcoming verses 6, 7 and 8.
Ajopi sannavyayatma bhutanamishwaropi sanna prakritim swamadhishthaya sambhavamyatma mayaya yada yada hi dharmasya glanir bhavati bharata abhyutthanam dharmasya tadatmanam srijamyaham paritranaya sadhunam vinashaya cha duskritam dharma samsthapanarthaya sambhavami yuge yuge.
Suddenly the blackboard teacher has to manifest, right? So what is the concept of avatara? Because Bhagavan is telling, again and again and again I have been born. But first we have to establish Bhagavan's ajopi. Ajaha api, though I am unborn, ajaha api san, though being unborn, avyayatma, though I am imperishable. Hey Arjuna, I am unborn, I am imperishable, and yet I am born and I die. Say, Bhagavan, that is very interesting. You are unborn, but you are born. and you are imperishable, but you perish. How? So Bhagavan says, that is what is my difference. You think you are perishable and you perish. You think you are born and therefore you are born, but I am unborn and yet born. I am imperishable and yet I am perishable. Both are me. So first, this avatar siddhanta is present in our culture. So first we have to establish what is Bhagavan's actual nature. So there were some people who are asking, Swamiji, is God there? If God is not there, there is no avatar. And therefore we have to first establish that there is God. How do we establish that there is God? We all believe in the concept, every effect has a... Do we have any doubt about it? No.